everyone. Happy Tuesday and Happy New Year. This is the first Tough Love Tuesday since the start of the new year. I hope you're sliding into 2021 with ease and grace and excitement. I'm actually still working, finessing my goals and things for this year. It's definitely been a busy week. For those of you who have been kind of following along with me, you know that next week, the Quit Sugar Summit goes live. So this is the world's largest online summit focused around sugar addiction. We have over 50 of the world's top leading experts, MDs and scientists and chefs and professors and real people as well, sharing their stories around sugar and sugar addiction. And obviously I'm sharing my story as well. I actually just filmed my interview with my co-host Mike today. We left it to the last minute. So much fun. You can grab the link above, go and register for free. The event kicks off next week. So yes, things have been very full around here, and I haven't had time to sit down and do the goals that I wanted to, but I know they'll get done, one thing at a time. So I'm so excited to tune in again for another incredible segment. And we've had some amazing new members joining our community here, this little free group on Facebook. And I just want to say a huge shout out. So glad that you're here. I hope that you tune in and enjoy these videos every week and start diving into this community. I want to remind everyone as well, before I share some serious tough love, some awesome serious tough love with all of you today, that this is your community. So please, introduce yourself, engage with each other, ask for help, ask for support. This is your space to really be surrounded by others who are on the same journey as you, and to really open up and feel safe and start, getting what you need. I mean, we're all at such a different stage with our journey, and the inner work or our journey around food. And this is what I wanted to actually talk about today. So let's get into this, because I know I promised these videos in 10 minutes or less. So I better be careful, or else I'm gonna be talking way too long, because I've just been on calls all day yesterday, on all day today about the summit, doing some final interviews, if you can believe it or not. And so I'm amped up. I'm excited. I can't contain myself. I can't wait for Monday, for next week. It's gonna be so much fun. So I hope that you're joining us. Let's get to it today, though. Okay, so what I want to share with you today, and actually some of you might not know this, I don't have these planned in advance. I do have a whole list of ideas of some tough love topics that I want to bring up for all of you, but I really, tune in intuitively with what you need today and what I feel like sharing today. So literally a half an hour ago, I decided what I was going to share today, and it comes out of some conversations that I've even had this morning. And I think is one of the foundational mindset shifts that we can make to understand our relationship with food, our relationship with ourselves, and start to shift that relationship in a way that lasts, right? So, we've all done the yo-yo dieting thing, one diet after another, and it doesn't stick. It doesn't last. It doesn't work for us. So here's the truth. You ready? Here's the love, the truth wrapped up in a bubble of love, okay? Because your outer world, okay, the habits you have, the tendencies you have towards sugar, the addictive behaviors, the unhealthy relationships you're in, the job that you hate, your outer world is a direct reflection of your inner world. I want to say that again. Okay, maybe I'll say it differently. Your inner world creates your outer world. So it's not about willpowering and changing habits, which are great, but it's about looking inward for real change. So if you want to stop struggling and stop, beating your head against the wall, which I can definitely relate to, you have to be willing to look inward, okay? Because these patterns that we're running are subconscious. They're inside. These are patterns, whether it's, numbing out using food and sugar, or being in abusive relationship after abusive relationship. And the reason why this is a tough pill to swallow for so many people is because when we start to really take personal responsibility, when we really start to acknowledge that all of the places in our life that we're very unhappy, or that we, aren't aligned with, are our own creation. Mic drop. Okay. It is really, can be a really tough pill to swallow. And I know this personally from experience in my own, journey into entrepreneurship and starting my own business. And I'm so grateful for the mentors that I had really beat this into me and really for me to understand that what the thoughts that I'm telling myself on a daily basis, the beliefs that I'm believing about myself and the world, my identity, all of these pieces needed to shift before my outer world shifted. And it did. So the work that I've done around my limiting beliefs about money and about myself and my ability to show up as a good coach, you know, my limiting beliefs around, you know, how the world works and how relationships should look in my life. When I actually shifted those, everything changed. Last year was the most successful year that I've had in my business and in my relationships and in all of these areas that as I've done this inner work, they've changed. Nothing out there has changed. Everything in here has changed. The way that I view myself, the way that I think about myself, the beliefs that I have about myself and the world has changed. And it directly rippled out and affected the things in my life on the outside. The habits I had, the relationships I had, the business that I had. And it's really, you know, it's one thing to understand this truth, but to actually see it start shifting in your own life is pretty incredible. So this is the tough love I want to share with you today, because for some of you maybe watching this, that may be a really hard pill to swallow, that, you know, the unhappiness in your life and the things in your life that, you know, are not where you want them to be are your own creation. But on top of this, I really want to remind you and lean into the gratitude in that. So when I realized this, that, you know, my business wasn't making any money back in the day because of my own limiting beliefs and my own issues around money and around the beliefs that I had around that, when I realized that, I also was able to lean into fully trusting and knowing that that was for a reason. So this is kind of a whole nother topic for another day, but I want you to know that the reason you are where you are right now with the unhealthy patterns around food or the unhealthy relationships or whatever it is that's going on in your life that you're not 100% happy with. Yes, your inner world and your belief systems and your thoughts created that, but it's also for a reason. Because oftentimes we need to go through struggle in order to find the, to learn the lesson, to learn a universal lesson, or to learn, you know, what we actually want in life and what we actually deserve. So we need to repeat lessons until we learn them, right? And it can be a really bumpy and uncomfortable journey, but it's an important one. So I want to encourage you, as you take personal responsibility for your inner world, creating your outer world, I want you to also to remember to just trust that you are right now where you're meant to be for a reason. And that took me a long time to wrap my head around, because I was like, why would the universe want me to not be making any money in my business? I have so much to offer, and I'm so passionate about what I do, and I know what I do works, and the support that I give my clients is out of this world. What's going on? And, you know, I beat my head against a wall for so long, you know, in those thought patterns. And finally, when I started leaning into really honoring, okay, there are lessons right now that I'm learning that are for a reason, and that's why I'm not making money, which is, I hope you're following this, but it was really leaning into actually gratitude for the challenges and the really struggling years that I had the first couple years of my business. Deep, deep struggle, and I've never really spoken about that before, but this is a perfect example of that, of what I'm talking about. And, you know, when I really leaned into acknowledging and trusting, like, okay, I'm in this struggle to learn something, and to really, and I know what it is now. I know that it was so that I had the time to do the inner work that now I get to share with my clients. And this was the biggest gift and epiphany for me last year, is realizing that if my business had been crazy, out of this world, big, the first year that I started it, there's no way I would have taken the time to do the inner work that I've done over the last, you know, 3 or 4 years to be able to now support my clients at a deeper level. So I know that it was part of my soul's evolution and the work that I'm meant to do here on this planet to not be financially successful in my business. I was very successful in lots of other ways up until that point. So, you know, this inner world and this inner work that I'm always talking about when it comes to, you know, repatterning our relationship with sugar, with food, with ourselves, is really, you know, when we shift our inner stuff, we'll call it, all of the outer stuff changes and we get what we want and things fall into place and eating healthy becomes effortless and we attract the most amazing people into our lives. And the most amazing job, we could become aligned with what we actually want to contribute to this world. And, you know, I want all of that for all of you. And I know you want that for yourself too. So that's the little snippet. Obviously, this is a huge conversation. I love having this conversation, but it came up today earlier in my interview that I was talking about for the Quit Sugar Summit. And I wanted to share that with all of you because it's really at the base of everything I do with my clients, is that deep understanding of what's going on the inside is reflecting on the outside. So the outside is just signals, right? Like if we can't stop reaching for food every single night or every time we're stressed, that's just a sign telling you that there's something out of alignment on the inside. And when we can figure out what that is, repattern it, shift it, your whole world will change. And it is so exciting. And I've experienced it myself, so I can stand here really confidently and share this is true. So I hope that that hits home for you. I hope that that's supportive. And I hope that you're willing to start looking inward and start looking at where these patterns on the outside are actually showing up, or where the root cause of them is on the inside, whether it's your thought patterns or your beliefs or your identity about yourself or all the pieces, right? Well, past traumas, people-pleasing tendencies, all these things, all the fun things on the inside. So I want you to start taking a look at that and just taking one step in that direction, even just being aware of this. Hopefully this tough love has helped. And now I'm over 10 minutes, so I'm wrapping this up. Don't forget to come and join the Quit Sugar Summit. We're kicking things off on Monday. I can't believe it. We have over 50 experts. Mike and I have been very busy interviewing behind the scenes. Lots of fun. I've met some incredible people. I've had some really powerful interviews where I'm welling up in tears. There's some serious inspiration and motivation. So if you're wanting to kick off 2021 and really reinvent yourself from the inside out, definitely come and check out this summit. You're not going to want to miss it. You're going to love it. And obviously, I can't wait to see you there. So thanks for joining. And don't forget to drop a comment below this video. I'd love to hear what comes up for you. Do you believe that your inner world creates your outer world? I'd love to hear that down below. I know that this can be a tough one, but let's keep the conversation going below this video. And I look forward to seeing you next week.